a long-awaited hug and welcome home to Nebraska. On this same day, a new warning for U.S. troops in Afghanistan. The U.S. says troops should brace for increased violence in Afghanistan. Good evening, I'm Melissa Fry.
And I'm Adrian Witset. Today's warning comes as Nebraska soldiers arrive home. KETV News Watch 7's Kyle Gravlin is live. Kyle?
Peace of mind for families of Nebraska Guard troops. Tonight, they'll fall asleep knowing their loved ones are safe at home.
Signs and smiles. And then, the welcome home. Families reunited. A long year of separation is over. The troops are home from Afghanistan.
It's good to be home. It's good to be in the real world.
Sergeant Greg Vaughn returned Thursday to friendly faces and familiar turf. He's part of Agribusiness Development Team Number 3. The unit has served several tours, trying to help build the agriculture industry in Afghanistan, teaching how to grow sustainable crops that can provide food and money to the country.
A lot of the experienced farmers and everything were gone, so they're just kind of living on the skin of their teeth, really.
Safely back home, it's hard for these Guard members to define the success of their mission, but they know they've planted a seed. And while they volunteer to serve, there's nothing quite like completing the tour.
Last week was like the whole 9 months, or the whole 11 months, actually.
Yeah, but it was 11, yeah, it did. You got to it.
It took forever.
Andrea Vaughn takes note of what's changed since her husband left for Afghanistan.
All the family things, the kids getting bigger, and
yeah.
I don't think we had any new grandchildren, thank goodness.
The 43rd Operational Support Airlift Detachment also was a part of today's homecoming. We asked the Guard members how they were received by the people of Afghanistan, and they said they got along well. A member of the AG unit told us the people recognized the people there recognized the U.S. troops were there to help.
Adrian? All right, Kyle Gravlin on today's homecoming from Afghanistan.